Hello guys and welcome to my new video. I have a phone in my hand right now because I'm planning on filming a Q&A. A lot of you have been asking me a bunch of questions everywhere. A lot of you wanted me to make a Q&A video on this channel, so here I am. And guys, you've asked a lot of nice questions. Thank you so much. If you want your question answered, make sure to follow me on Instagram and watch my stories because this is usually where I post my questions. A lot of people wanted to know how they can go from intermediate to advanced level. This is a really, really good question, and thank you so much for asking. I have a video on my channel which is specifically dedicated to how to actually go from intermediate to advanced. So guys, I highly recommend you go watch this video because I go in depth about everything, about all the tips on how I managed to do it, what personally helped me. I also actually have a video on my channel about how to go from beginner to intermediate. So if you're still a beginner, don't worry, it's totally fine. So make sure to watch one of those videos if you want to. But here I'm just gonna try to answer this question really quick because I know a lot of you wanna hear the answer to this question. So what personally helped me is just studying English consistently and also trying to like create this language environment around myself. I always talk about like creating this English atmosphere around you, you know? You can do that by watching like a TV show every single day, or like watching YouTube videos in English every single day, or reading in English. You know, for me it was more like and not like or, you know, I was doing this and that. I wasn't just concentrating on listening to music in English. I was doing a lot of different things at the same time. I think what also helped me is preparing for exams, because I actually took IELTS and TOEFL. So it was a lot of exams, a lot of preparations, and I also had the English class in college. Obviously, I had an English exam every single year, and I think this whole system of testing for me personally, it was good because it kind of like encouraged me to study English. If you're also like a person like me, you can try doing different tests too, but if you obviously don't want to pay, because IELTS and TOEFL, you have to pay for them, you can just, you know, organize like mock tests at home, because there are a lot of free tests online, like, you know, preparation tests for IELTS or TOEFL. You can do something like this, why not? Another question was developing your writing skills. A lot of people think it's pretty hard to be able to develop your writing in English, or I mean in any foreign language. It is hard to write, I completely agree with you. For me, it's hard to write in Chinese, extremely hard, in French, even harder, because I've just started to kind of like dedicate more time to French. So when we talk about English, what helped me is having like an English diary, if it makes sense, or like a journal, because now I actually have a bullet journal. I bought it off Amazon, and you know, I kind of like create this spreads in English, everything here is in English, and I try to journal in English. You know, if I have any, for example, any tasks that I need to do like every single day, I read all of them in English, and this way I stay productive. I also try to be creative, right? Because to create all of those spreads, I need to kind of like, I don't know, use some markers and, you know, pens and like different fonts too. And I also learn English, right? And you can do this in any language you want to. I'm sure that a lot of you have to-do lists every single day. Instead of just buying a whole bullet journal, if you're not sure if you're gonna like it, why not to just write those to-do lists in English, for example, right? Or when you go grocery shopping. I think a lot of you write like shopping lists. This is personally what I do, and I think this is like a mini writing practice that can help you in the long run as well. What is your daily routine of learning a language? This is a really, really cool question, guys. Thank you so much. So what I usually do for English, for example, I never do any grammar exercises or anything like this. If I see a grammar rule, I know this rule. Obviously, sometimes when I speak, I do make mistakes and I understand that. It's totally fine. But for me, I find it boring right now, so I don't do grammar right now at all. What I do is I try to imagine that I am like an American, for example, right? Because I want to focus on the American English. So what would a person who lives in America do, right? They would do everything in English. For example, if I want to find a recipe to cook, I Google everything in English. If I want to watch a movie, I watch it in English. If I want to read a book, I read it in English. And there is obviously an upside and a downside. The upside being that obviously I improve my English, but the downside is that I don't practice my native language that much. And right now, sometimes I find it hard when like a Russian speaker talks to me and uses certain idioms, and I'm like, whoa, I haven't heard this idiom in such a long time. I obviously understand what it means, but just like, you know, reality hits me and I realize that I haven't read a book in Russian in more than 3 years, or even like 4 or 5 years. It's been a really long time. For Chinese and French, I obviously still use textbooks, because for French, I do grammar, because grammar is extremely hard in French. Chinese grammar is a little bit different. It's not that hard. Even like in English, grammar is harder than in Chinese. In Chinese, I focus primarily on learning as much vocabulary as possible. So if you're interested in what I actually use to study Chinese, you can watch a video on my vlog channel. Like the first video, I talk about like what resources I use to study Chinese. This is a really good question, guys. How to understand English jokes? For me as an Asian, it's difficult because of cultural differences. When I talk to English speakers, I do have like situations when they joke about something and I'm like, eh? What? Like, what are you talking about? Obviously, I don't get some of the jokes. You can look at the situation in two ways. The first one, you can be like, oh, sad because you don't get the joke. But the second, you can be like, okay, that's a great opportunity for me to learn this joke, to remember it, right? And you should just ask your friend, can you please explain it? Because like, I don't understand because of this language barrier, right? Maybe if I knew this joke, I would laugh. I would be like, whoa, that's interesting. Yeah, that's cool. And so this is where being brave comes in, right? You should just say, be honest, I don't get this joke. So this is what you should do in this situation. But the question was how to actually probably learn jokes, right? There are actually some of the books with English jokes, but I think I've only read one of them. If I find it, I'll link it in the description. But some of the other ways is to actually watch comedy movies or comedy TV shows, because this is where people joke the most. And if you feel like they're joking, right, they're like saying a joke and you don't understand it, try Googling it. Usually you'll be able to find an answer in like a matter of seconds. This is what I personally do, especially when I was watching Friends. I've actually watched like all of the seasons. I absolutely love this TV show, and they do joke a lot, right? They use a lot of different expressions and like cultural things, and I was constantly Googling. I was like, what does this mean? What does that mean, right? And I still remember this first time when I was like, I do not understand what they're talking about. It was about the ball dropping. There's like this tradition in New York. They have like, there's like a ball that drops and something like this. You can Google it, right? You can watch this episode if you're interested. 3, 2, 1. And when I first heard them talk about that, I was like, what are they talking about? What ball? Like, what ball is dropping? What are they even talking about? But then I Googled, right? I Googled and was like, oh, now I get it. So that's what you should do, right? When you watch a TV show, don't feel sad and discouraged, just Google. Yeah, because we have such an amazing resource, internet nowadays. How can I improve my reading? It is so, so bad. I feel like when I read the books, it takes so much time. I have a video on my channel about reading. First, you should watch this video. But here, I'm just gonna say that to be able to enjoy reading, you should read the books that are your level. If you feel like they're hard, they're difficult for you, just stop reading because you're not gonna enjoy this. You should start with graded readers, like the books that were kind of transformed for non-native speakers. Even if you're not a beginner, start with the beginner level, because if you feel so demotivated and sad that you're never gonna love reading ever again, just start with something easy, right? And then you're gonna feel like, whoa, this book is so easy. I know all the words, all the expressions are so cool. And then maybe go a little bit higher, you know, choose a more difficult level. And I'm sure this way, you'll be able to enjoy reading way, way more. I'd like to know more how to use Anki. Show us a real study session. Thank you for this question. I've recently uploaded a video about Anki, and I have another video on my channel about Anki as well. So I link both of them in the description. I absolutely love Anki, and I recommend everyone to try this app out. For your desktop, it's completely free. This is basically an app to memorize new vocabulary. When did you start learning every single language, and what is your level in every single language you're learning? So I started learning English when I was still like in elementary school, you know, like in a lot of schools you have to learn English as a second language, but obviously I was just a kid, you know, I didn't really care about English at all, so I wasn't really studying it that much. And I started learning French when I was in middle school, like I think it was in sixth grade or something like this. And I started learning Chinese during my freshman year in college, because I actually picked a program called Asian Studies. So it's like dedicated to learning the Chinese language. You can actually pick any Asian language. We could pick between Chinese, Japanese, Korean, and Arabic, and I picked Chinese. And when we talk about my current level in all of those languages, for English, I believe my level is advanced. For Chinese, intermediate, definitely, maybe like upper when I really try. When I do my Chinese consistently, it's probably like closer to upper intermediate. And my French is now like a beginner. I'm definitely a beginner in French. When and how did you train your pronunciation? There was one moment when I was in college, I realized that I was speaking in British English and in American English and in Russian English at the same time. I was not happy about that. You know, if you're happy about your accent, it's totally fine. But for me, I was like, I want to improve my accent. I want to do something to sound more fluent, to sound like an American, because for me, I wanted to learn the American accent. And then I just started researching. I started Googling like crazy. I started buying books to improve my American accent. And I obviously always recommend this book, Mastering the American Accent, because it just blew my mind. I was like, huh, this is really how Americans say that, right? And I also subscribe to the Rachel's English channel because she posts a lot about improving your accent, and this is what I wanted to do, right? So I watched a bunch of her videos. I worked on my pronunciation for a long time, and I am still working on it, you know, because when I talk to my friends, it's a little bit easier to have a better pronunciation because I don't feel like I'm under pressure. But when I first started filming YouTube videos, for example, it was a little bit uncomfortable because no one is born with the ability to speak on camera, right? And especially if it's your second language. It's not even my native language, right? And I was really, really scared. And obviously when you're scared, when you're not comfortable, your accent is way worse than it really is. So my tip for you is if you wanna improve your accent, make sure you really work on it. Make sure you download a lot of resources, you watch a bunch of videos specifically dedicated to improving your accent. And I also have some of the videos on my channel, and you can check them out as well. Oh, and there was also another question about which accent is easier, American accent or British accent. I think the American accent is easier personally for me, and a lot of people think this way as well. But I think some people would say that the British accent is easier. So I think if you're not sure, just try to experiment. Watch some videos about the American accent and see if you like it, see if you like how it sounds, try to pronounce certain words with the American accent. If you like, okay, it's fine, maybe you can try the British accent as well, and then you can kind of like find the best one for you. And I think I'm gonna answer the last question for today. And the question is about using subtitles when you watch anything in English. My tip is, when you first start, obviously it's gonna be extremely hard for you to understand native speakers when they speak, and you should definitely use subtitles. To be honest, I use subtitles every single time I watch a movie or a TV show, because sometimes, you know, there are certain accents that are a little bit more difficult to understand, and I just wanna make sure that the subtitles are there. I don't always look at them, but when I do look at them, I like the fact that they're there. But I don't use subtitles when I watch YouTube videos. The reason why is because I usually watch videos of like English speaking people, right? And they usually don't include subtitles in their videos. And the other reason is that they usually talk about very basic things in the videos, right? So for me, I don't feel the need to use subtitles. So my advice here is gonna be, try to maybe not use subtitles when you watch YouTube videos about, like, you know, if you watch a video about like my daily routine or something like this. You probably already know all of those phrases, like to get up in the morning, to have breakfast, things like that. But when you watch a movie, yeah, obviously the accent is gonna be maybe a little bit weird, and there are gonna be a lot of words you don't understand. So use subtitles and don't be ashamed of that. So yeah, guys, thank you for all the questions. I've answered a lot of them in this video, and I hope maybe in the future I'll make another Q&A. If you want your question answered, make sure to follow me on Instagram, and obviously subscribe to my YouTube channel to see even more videos from me. If you wanna get more resources to learn English, to learn even more words, you can definitely check out my Patreon page. See you next time. Bye.